we've got three methods for solving exponential equations. One, like basis. Two, brute force. Hard to say. Trial and error. Three, we're going to use a logarithm, but we're not getting there today. So on your notes, example one, it's on the top of the second page, looks like this. 4 to the x equals 124. We looked at the chart a minute ago, and there is no common base for 124 and 4. You can't do this one with like bases. So we're going to go with trial and error. We're going to build us a little chart. We're going to try different values of x, and we're going to see what happens with 4 to the x. If x is 2, then 4 squared is 16. I need 124. 2 is too small of an exponent. If x is 3, 4 to the third, if you refer back to your chart, 4 times 4 times 4 is 64, still too small. If x is 4, 4 to the fourth power, what is that? 256. Way too big. I'm needing 124, something between 64 and 256, so that suggests to me that the exponent that I need is somewhere between 3 and 4. So pick something between 3 and 4.
3.4.
Like 3.4, 3.5. We'll just jump right into the middle of it. Do this on your calculator. I need some rapid fire calculator operators. So 4 to the 3.5, what do you get?
128.
That was a little big, right? So let's go down a little. Let's make our exponent maybe 3.4. Somebody tell me, what is 4 to the 3.4 power?
111.430.
Guess what? 3.4 is too small. 3.5 is too big. We need something between those. So we're gonna think of this as 3.40 and 3.50 and go somewhere between 40 and 50. So let's try 3.45. Somebody tell me, 4 to the 3.45 power, what do we get?
119.428.
119? 119.42 something. A little small. So let's try maybe 3.46.
121.09.
Still a little small. Let's try 3.47.
122.76.
Okay, 122 point something. So let's try 3.48. What does that give us? If you do 4 to the 3.48 power?
124.499.
Okay. That's getting pretty close, but not close enough, because I want you to keep working until you can give me the first decimal place as a zero.
Okay.
So we know that 3.47 is a little too small and 3.48 is a little too big, because we need 124.0. And so let's try something. Let's think of this as 3.470 and 3.480. And let's go with something between them.
75.
Okay, so let's try 3.475. Type into your calculator. 4 raised to the power of 3.475. Somebody tell me what you get.
123.9.
Is it? 6. 0.6? A little too small. And so, if we need to jump it up, try 3.476.
123.8.
Okay. Try 3.477.
123.98,
I think it is. So still a little small. Try 3.478. 124.15. Okay, you see where we are? I want you to get it close enough to give me 124.0. So we are between 124.0 is between 123.98 and 124.115, so that means the exponent has to be something between these two. So if we call this 4770 and 4780,
it's still 3.4773.
3.4773, will that do it? 124.0.
72 does it.
I think actually if we're only matching it to 124.0, I think this last number could be a 2 or a 3.
It's a 2.
I think both will work. So I'll take it for now. I'll take it as a 2. I'll take it as a 3.
The 2 is a little closer.
124.0 something. 2 is a little closer.
771.
771, does that one work also?
Mm-hmm. But it's too big.
If you do 771, it'll give you 124.0 as the first decimal place.
000.
000?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If we do 4771, it'll give us 124.000. So here's what we have found. When we solve this, the exponent that we need is approximately 3.4771. That will give us, if you use this number as your exponent, you'll get 124.000. It's not exact, but there are still some other numbers out here past it. But we got pretty darn close. Okay, here's one more. Example 2. On example 2, you have 7 times 10 to the x equals 352. Would it be okay if I just multiplied 7 times 10 and got 70? That completely changes the base. The base is supposed to be 10 raised to a power. So you can't multiply order of operations, right? You've got to deal with exponents before you multiply. So to make this easier to solve, what should we do first? You got it. You divide both sides by 7. Then 10 to the x equals, let's round to 3 decimal places. So did you get 50.286? Here we go again. I want you to keep working until you can match those 3 decimal places. So x and 10 to the x. If x is 1, 10 to the first is 10. Too small. If x is 2, 10 to the second is 100. Too big. We want to get 50. It's somewhere in between here, 50.286. So what does that tell us about our exponent? Where should it fall? Between 1 and 2? So we'll jump right in the middle and try 1.5. Anybody have it?
31.6.
Okay. 31.6, too small, right? So what does that tell me about the exponent? Needs to be a little bigger, right? So let's try 1.7. 10 to the 1.7.
50.1.
It's better.
But 10 to the 1.8 is 63.0.
1.8. 10 to the 1.8 is 60. You're back to the field?
Yep.
All right, good luck.
Thank you.
60 point something. Okay, so here's
the 3. But
63. Okay. So we know that the exponent, we're looking for 50.286. It's got to be between 1.7 and 1.8. Which one is it closer to?
1.7.
Yeah, okay. So if you try 1.71, I'm going to extend this around over here. So if we try 1.71,
it's too big.
What do we get?
51.286.
Yeah, I think I remember this. 51.286. At first you look at that and you go, hey, we got it. It matched 0.286. Oh, no, we didn't, because it's 51 and it needs to be 50. So this is a little bit too big, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what does that tell us? 1.7 was too small. 1.71 was too big. We had one, so we're going to think of this as 1.70 gave us 50.1. 1.71 gave us 51.286. Guess what? It's somewhere between these. So think of this as 700 and this as 710. And then what's something between? 1.705 maybe? Anybody have 1.705?
50.69.
699, I think. A little big, right? So try 702. Anybody have 1.702?
50.350.
Still a little big, right? Try 1.701.
Small.
What is it?
50.283.
Oops. So what do we know? We've got to match until we get 286.
Yeah, it
2, 3, 4. Oh, sorry. 2, 3, 4. So it's got to be somewhere between these two. Think of this as 7,010 and this is 7,020. What's something between those?
1.7015.
Anybody have it?
Oh,
it's got to be between 7,010 and 7,020. So if you try 7,015,
it's telling me over.
Wait, do we want the decimal after to be a zero or just
one
to round
to the,
down?
Okay, if you type in 10 raised to the 1.7015, you got what?
No, do we want the decimal to, after to be the fourth decimal to be a zero or just
it
to
can
round
just
down?
Be, just as long as you have 0.286, I'll take it.
Okay.
Anybody have it? Since
yeah.
We're about to run out of time.
1.7014.
Yeah, so 1.70145. Will that give us 50.286? It's a little bit of a tedious process, right?
Yeah.
So by the time you do trial and error, you will definitely appreciate a logarithm. Will you stop that for now?
Logarithms.
So look at